Lecture 2. Combinational logic. This logic does so-called parallel logic operations on variables whose values are available simultaneously. So its other name is parallel logic. We shall start with principle of Boolean algebra or logic algebra. Logic algebra deals with variables that may assume just two values, either yes or no. This algebra was designed by George Boole, who lived at the beginning of 19th century in England. He was a self-taught mathematician and philosopher. He is famous for his Boolean algebra, but he is also known as an author of several works on relationship between the concepts of Holy Trinity and God as an absolute unity. Next, we will move on to DeMorgus' theorem. DeMorgus' theorem allows us to simplify Boolean operations. Augustus DeMorgus lived at the same time as George Boole, and he was Boole's follower. He was also an amateur of spiritualism and clear vision. Then we will proceed to particular examples of simplifications of Boolean functions. Boolean algebra. Object of Boolean algebra can have only two values, logical 0 or logical 1, or no and yes. Boolean algebra defines two possible operations, logical addition or OR operation and logical multiplication AND operation. These operations have following postulated properties. First, closure. If two elements x and y are Boolean, then their logical sum and logical product are also Boolean. Second, there are identity elements. For OR operation, identity element is 0, such that a plus 0 is the same a. For AND operation, identity element is 1, a times 1 is 1. Commutative property. X plus y is the same as y plus x. X times y is the same as y times x. Distributive property. X times y plus z equals x times y plus x times z. This is so far very similar to our regular algebra. But next, be attention, x plus y times z can be opened up as x plus y times x plus z. Very unusual, but this is how it is postulated in logic algebra. Finally, complement or inverse. If element x is Boolean, then there exists element x prime, also Boolean, such that x plus x prime will be equal to 1, and x times logical times x prime equals 0. Just like conventional algebra, Boolean algebra has its own theorems. Fortunately, Boolean algebra deals only with two elements and two operations, so these theorems can be easily proven just by direct substitution. I am leaving this proof for you and only listing these theorems. Inverse of inverse is the same. Variable multiplied by itself gives the same variable. Inverse A plus A gives us 1. Inverse A times A gives us 0. A plus 0 returns A. A plus 1 returns 1. A times 0 element returns 0 element. A times 1 element returns A. These theorems are usually very well understandable. A little bit more counterintuitive is DeMorgus' theorem. A plus B inverse is the same as A inverse times B inverse. A times B inverse is the same as A inverse plus B inverse. Proof of this theorem can be done by direct substitution of A's and B's, zeros and ones, or logical yes and logical no. Consider a simple example of using DeMorgus theorem. Suppose we have a task to build XOR gate using NAND elements only. So let me remind you what is XOR gate. XOR gate or exclusive OR gate is denoted in diagrams like this. And its table of truth is such that it produces it produces zeros whenever both inputs A and B are equal to each other, and it produces one whenever A and B are different. So let's try first to write this table of truth algebraically. Look where it gives us logical ones. So first row when gives ones, 0, 1 gives 1. So for 0, A prime for 1 times B plus another row when gives 1 is this one. 1, 0 is 1. So plus A times B prime. So this is algebraic expression for OR gate, for XOR gate. Now, let's apply to this algebraic expression DeMorgus theorem. To do this, I take this F and invert it 2 times. And then I plug in the value here. And then I am using first statement from DeMorgus theorem. And I am rewriting my expression like this. And now you see all logic operations that I need to do indeed can be done with NAND elements only. Well, of course, this is a pretty simple problem, and we could have solved it just by thinking very hard without applying DeMorgus theorem. But DeMorgus theorem is good because it allows us to obtain solution very quickly. And here is a practical possible realization of XOR gate using only NAND elements. Let's look here. Variable A goes to first NAND gate, goes to both inputs of it. As a result, we have here A prime. Variable B coming here directly, so in this way we have just B. This NAND gate produces for us A prime B prime. Let's look at the second pass. Element B coming to NAND element becoming B prime, and in this way element A is coming. So this NAND gate produces for us A, B, prime, prime. And then finally, we will have, after the final NAND gate, we will have what we need. You may ask me, why do we need to solve problems like this if XOR gates, I told you, last time exist in form of separate microchips. Well, it depends what you want to do and who you are. Very often manufacturers are looking for way to make the product as cheap as possible. And it is often easier and cheaper to learn how to produce just one or two sorts of gates and use them all the time, rather than design whole variety of gates separately. So it's just a question what is more profitable in mass production. These sort of problems appear often. One of the consequences of DeMorgus' theorem is that any logic function we should be able to present in two equivalent forms. Either as a sum of products, I call it SOP, or as a product of sums, I will call it POS. Example, consider Boolean function given by this table of truths. And let's present it algebraically. If we want to present it as a sum of products, we have to look for the lines that give for us that result in logical one. And write these lines algebraically. 0, 0, 1, x prime times y prime times z. Next line that gives us one, this one. 0, 1, 0. For 0 we write x prime, for y, for 1 we write y, for 0 again we write z prime. And so on, 1, 0, 0 gives us x, y prime, z prime, 1, 1, 0 produces x, y, z prime, and 1, 1, 1 produces obviously x, y, z. And then we sum all of these elements up, and our answer will be given, our function f will be expressed in algebraic form as a sum of products. Let's do it as a product of sums. For products of sums, we have to look for lines that result in zeros and write them in the form of sums, substituting variables for zeros or inverted variables whenever we see one. So, for example, first line, 0, 0, 0 produces 0. That's our line that we should pick up. So, 0, 0, 0 means x plus y plus z. Next line that produces 0 is this line. 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1 would mean x plus y prime plus z prime. And one more line that produces z, 0 is 1, 0, 1. It would translate to x prime plus y plus z prime. And now we have to multiply all of this. And then we will have a representation of our function f in form of the product of sum. F equals x plus y plus z times x plus y prime plus z prime times x plus y plus z prime. Once again, if we want to present our function as a sum of products, we have to look for lines in table of truths where it results in ones. If we want to present our function as a product of sum, we have to look in the table of truths for lines that result in zero. And in the first case, we write these lines as products and sum them up. In the second case, we write these lines as sums and multiply them. Simplification of functions. There are numerous ways to simplify Boolean functions. The first and most obvious way is just to use algebraic laws that we considered earlier. For example, we have function f equals not x, not y, z plus not x, y, z plus x, but not y. We may use our partialates and we can see that we may take x prime z in these two terms, we may take them outside parentheses. So we have x prime z times y prime plus y. And the last term is left. Y prime plus y, we know this is 1. So now we are left with x prime times z plus x times y prime. Another example, f equals x prime plus xy. We may use distributive law, which is the one which is counterintuitive to us, but we have to use it. So x prime plus xy can be written as x prime plus x times x prime plus y. And then x prime plus x is 1. So we have x prime plus y. This is the answer. The other method is graphical method. Let's consider graphical method starting from second example, because this is simpler. We draw two circles. One circle symbolizes x. Whatever inside this purple circle is x. Whatever outside this circle is not x. And draw red circle, y. Whatever is inside red circle is y. Whatever is outside of red circle is not y. And now let's shade the areas. Not x. I am shading with purple, not x. Everything that is outside x circle, everything is not x. Now I have to shade x times y. X times y, I shade it with red color. It's just this segment where x and y circles overlap, xy. And now whatever I shaded is the answer. And if we look at this, we indeed may say that our function can be described as everything that is not x plus this little segment, but we may say plus y. Of course, some part of elements is double counted, but it does not matter for us. Function gives, result of the function will be the same. So we may say that our function is indeed, f equals x prime plus y. Let's go back to first example. Similarly, we draw circles. Purple circle for x. What is inside is x. What is outside is not x. Green circle is for y. And red circle is for z. Now we have to shade the areas. First, x prime, y prime, z means not x, not y, but z. Not x, not y, but z. This is shaded with red color. This is this section of the circle. Not x, not y, but z. Let's shade second term, not x, but y times z. Y times z would be this thing, but overlap of y and z circles. But it has to be not x, so we have smaller, we have this segment. Not x, but y times z. And finally, we have to shade x, but not y. So x is this purple circle, but not y, means purple circle with small byte. Now we have to look at our shaded areas carefully, and we may see that it indeed can be presented as not x, not x by z, not x by z gives us this thing, not x by z, plus x, but not y. And of course, again, some area here is double counted, but we are not concerned about it, because it still gives us the same answer. So f equals x prime z plus x y prime. Example 3. The function is given by this expression f equals xyz plus x prime y plus xyz prime.
We may simplify it algebraically and get the answer that this is just y. Let's now do this simplification graphically. Again, purple circle will stay for x. Green circle will stay for y. Red circle will stay for z. Now, let's shape areas. First area is x, y, z. X, y, z is where all three circles intersect. So this is my x, y, z. Second area, not x, but y. Y, but not x. It's like this. So this is y, but not x. And the final area is xy, but not z. Xy is intersection of x and y circles, but not z means this small segment xy, not z. So we see that we are ending up with having y circle all shadowed in different colors. So the answer is indeed f equals y. Example 4. Consider function f equals zx plus cx prime y. With algebraic transformations, we are obviously bringing to the form f equals z times x plus z times y. Let's do the same simplification graphically. Again, purple circle stays for x, green circle stays for y, and red circle stays for z. Let's shade areas. First term, zx. Zx is intersection of z and x, this one. This is zx. Second term, z, not x, y. So zy, but not x. Zy, not x. So second term is this one. This one. Zy, but not x. And we can see that we indeed may write it as zx, that is showing this, plus zy, that is showing this segment. Of course, part of it, as usual, counted twice, but answer is the same. Let's think how we may implement this circuit. Let's do first implementation using AND and OR gates. So implement using AND OR gates. Just straightforward. We have three signals, x, y, and z. First, we have to do operation zx.
So,
zx will be done here. Second term, we have to do operation zy.
Okay, let's draw the nice.
And now we have to end them up with OR gate.
So let me label that this term gives us this wire is ZX and this wire is ZY. And the answer is ZX plus ZY.
Let's try to implement this differently using only NAND gates. Using NAND gates, we would need to apply to our function f DeMorgus theorem. So f is the same as f prime prime. So it would be z x plus zy prime and one more time prime.
Okay, let's put dots here.
Now what is inside of inner bracket can be rewritten as products of two prime brackets z x prime times z y prime and prime again. Now you can see that this indeed can be implemented only with NAND gates. Let's do it. We have again three signals x, y, and z. Zx prime, so zx, so I take wire z, bringing it to level of x, I am having n gate, I am having here circle for negation, and this is my zx prime. Now zy prime. Now I take z and y wires, draw another NAND gate, I have zy prime. Now I have to bring these both to one more NAND gate, which will produce me the answer. So, all the three NAND gates are sufficient to do it. Let me label what is what, so you will be able to follow me up. Z X prime is here in this wire. This wire carries Z Y prime. Well, and here's the answer.
this is the end of the second lecture.